Morning. You are at the Thursday 6 a.m. workout. I am Coach Steph. This is like the last time I have to announce this. There's a combine on Saturday. If you are available, like all day, if you could volunteer, that would be great because we're still short some volunteers. We could definitely use them. But that is the last time I'm going to announce that until the next combine. So I'm sure we'll have some kind of announcement next week. For our prep, let me just change the screen up here. It's a 5-minute AMRAP, so as many rounds as possible. We're going to run through the next four exercises for 5 minutes. You'll get through about, you'll get through probably 2.5 rounds. So first, we're going to start with a Spider-Man step up. So you're in a tall plank. Step up with one foot and twist in toward the knee, then switch. It's a total of 10, so it's 5 each side. Then we move into a side plank with hips up and down. So we have shoulders, hips, and knees all in one line, and we just lower our hips to the floor for 10. Then you roll on over, and we do 10 on the other side. Then we come on up to standing. We have a single leg calf raise. So whether your foot's out in front or foot's head back, doesn't matter, but you're just raising up on your calf. We've got 10 on one leg and then 10 on the other. We're working on your calf, actually like stretching it a little bit and strengthening it from yesterday. What did we do yesterday? We didn't do jump rope, but we did some burpees. So that, and then also work on ankle stability. So 10 each side. And then at the end, we do high knees, 20 of them total, 10 each side. Because really we would run 2 laps outside, but it's raining. So rather than run. Again, you'll get through about 2.5 rounds, and then we'll get started with our day. So let me put 5 minutes on the timer and check. Mike, so yeah, we can hear it in here too. And I don't have a jacket on. I don't know what's up with that. It was not scratchy in the 5 a.m. So I'm sorry. I'll try to move it around so it's not scratchy. She said the mic is scratchy and I don't know why. Sorry, guys. I'll play with it. All right. 5 minutes on the clock. When you're ready, you can come on down for those Spider-Man step-ups. I wonder if I need to change the battery. I don't know, but all right. So Spider-Man step ups, 5 each side. Good. So a total of 10 Spider-Man step-ups. Then we move into that side plank. Shoulders, hips, and knees in one line. And lower those hips 10 times down. Is the mic a little better, Joanna, or no? Still scratchy? Okay. I'm just going to hold this like this. So 10 side plank hips on one side. Roll on over, 10 on the other. Good morning. All right, then we've got those calf raises. So 1 foot up. We are just starting from the front, Spider-Man step-ups. So you got that tall plank, 1 foot twisting in. And take your time. There's no rush. Yeah. Good. So those calf raises, 10 each side. And then you have a total of 20 knee raises, high knees. You're going to do a side plank. And you're just going up and down with your hips. So 10 on one side, 10 on the other. And you're really not far behind. It took people the last class. They got through like 2.5 rounds. It wasn't that much. Good. As you finish those calf raises, 20 high knees, 10 each side, and right back into Spider-Man step-ups. Good. Good job, really sitting those hips down in those Spider-Man step-ups. Just over 90 seconds, so. Guys, I'm sorry, Joanna, you gotta hear. Feedback. I'll just stand here holding the mic all the time. About one more minute. So we just keep rolling through. About 30 seconds left. Good job rolling through. About 15 seconds. Changing the screens. All right, last five, three, two, and one. All right. Okay. So just like last week's workout on Thursday, we're going to have a similar structure. It's two 12-minute sections. Okay. We could all start in the same spot, or you can, it does not matter. You need a partner for this workout in here, and at home, I've structured it so you can do it on your own. So 12 minutes, as many rounds as possible. Last week, we tried to get you to do five, and some people kind of burnt out from trying to get five. Some didn't quite get there. So today, it's just as many rounds as possible. And if you are in the combine, be careful. Do not burn yourselves out today. Okay. Just kind of use it as like a way to warm up, get your heart rate up a little bit. But I would not burn out. And a lot of people aren't coming tomorrow. Not that I'm like officially saying don't ever come to the gym. But again, if you're going to compete on Saturday, you're going to get three full workouts. Most people aren't. So again, I just wouldn't burn out today. So for the first set, you're alternating exercises for the 12 minutes back and forth between those first two. So you would do a synchronized heavy rope sit-ups. We have heavy ropes over here. The two of you hold them. Remember, when you sit up, your head goes through the window and your shoulder blades come down at the same time. You have 20 of those, and then you each take turns to do 40 total single unders with a heavy rope. If the heavy rope is too tough for you, by all means, you can use a regular jump rope. Those are set up there. Or if even that's tough, taking a large plate, one of the 45-pound plates, and doing step ups instead, a total of 40. Okay. It's synchronized for the sit ups together. But then the heavy rope, the jump rope portion, whatever, is you go, I go. So one person does 40, then the other person does 40, then go back to sit-ups. And you just keep alternating between those two exercises the whole time. At home, you're going to do weighted sit-ups. So you can have either a kettlebell up top, a plate, a dumbbell, doesn't matter. 20 total weighted sit-ups. And then you do 40 jump ropes. If you have a jump rope, single unders, or if you don't have a jump rope and you want to do those penguin hops where you're slapping your sides. Or if you have something to step up on, just quick step ups. We just want cardio, 40 total. Okay. So you'll just keep going back and forth between your weighted sit-ups and the jump rope back and forth, okay, for 12 minutes. We have a 3-minute rest in between, and then you're going to switch gears and we move to set two. For set two, you're with your partner. You're going to do those synchronized wall ball throws. It's a total of 20. Make sure, come all the way down to a full squat. Let your legs help you push that ball. You want to touch that blue line along the top. Okay, so really using your legs to help you and then receiving that ball back. 20 total, and then you hop on the bike. I had to fight for this. It was supposed to be 40 calories or more, but it's you go, I go on the bike. It's a total of 40. And if you don't want to do 40, 30. So it means split it into 15s or 20s. But people were kind of struggling, but originally it was 40. And I was like, that's not nice. We're not doing 40. Like, we got to give a little bit lower. So take your time. Okay. Again, as many rounds as you can, but don't burn yourselves out trying to like crank through 15 or 20 calories. So it is split that number in half that time. So you're only doing 15 or 20 calories. It's not a total of 40 each. You'd be sitting on the bike for 12 minutes. We don't want to do that. At home, yours is, yes, I was just going to say, yep. Okay. So at home, I'm going to explain the dumbbell clean and press because people watch the, like, we know Dolly will be watching the replay. So dumbbell clean and presses, you have the two dumbbells, bring it up into your shoulders, drive it overhead, catch and down, which is kind of similar movement to the wall ball. Joanna's got a slam ball, so she's going to take it, clean it over her shoulder, throw it, and then run and get it. You have 20 total, and then you do, instead of the bike, because they're going to be doing 10 to 20 calories, you're doing 10 burpees. So just make sure you have good form on those burpees, hopping out, hopping in, and jump, okay? Just make sure, keep your, when you're hopping in, the thing that I'm seeing in here is a lot of people are jumping narrow and then it makes it harder on the knees. They're pressing out. Jump wide when you come back in. Jump wide and then jump. That'll just make it a little easier on your knees rather than having feet in and then your knees are pushing out. That makes sense. Does that make sense? I just saw a lot of that in here the other day and I didn't have time to explain. Just make sure you're jumping in. 10 total burpees. Go right back into that clean press movement. Okay, so we're all going to focus on just one of the sets. So at home, Joanna, you pick either set one or set two, but you're only doing the two exercises. I had a group in the last class. I don't know why, because they were here last Thursday, but they were trying to go back and forth between everything. You're either starting in set one, everything is heavy rope, or you start with set two, you're doing wall ball bike. Okay, same thing at home. You're either doing sit-ups and jump rope, but then you just keep rotating between those two. You don't go back and forth with everything. All right. So heavy ropes are over here and we'll just kind of work in this area. And the wall ball bike is in this area. All right. So wherever you pick your poison, they're both equally terrible and wonderful. Let me say that. So you pick wherever you would like to go first. Which, wherever you would like to go. And between the two exercises, you can pick which one you want to do first. There were some people who just wanted to start with the bike. That is fine as well. So you'll still need the heavy rope because you're going to do the sit-ups. Yeah. All right. All right, how we doing at home? Just about ready, Joanna? What? The heavy work? You know what? So I coached. All right, we look like we're just about ready. If you want to adjust that bike, if you need it to be the seat a little lower. No, whatever, however you want to do the bike. I usually have two dots above. That's my, I don't know, my comfort zone. All right, I'm going to start. So we have two rounds on the timer. They are 12 minutes each. And then there's a 3-minute transition where we're going to wipe down and switch sides. And then 12 minutes again. All right, we are going 10 seconds. All right, in 3, 2, 1, and go. Good. Nice weight, Joanna. Good. That's it. Yep. All right, Joanna, we got 40 single unders or step ups. Yep. Good. We are 3 minutes in. Good work, Joanna. Nice sit-ups. Good work, good work. Just over 6 minutes left. I see those step ups, Joanna. Good. And then not to kind of pick at you, make sure you do 20 with one foot forward and then switch to 20 with the other foot. Yep. I'm sure you were already going to do that, but just throwing that out there. Yeah. We are at the 3 minute mark, just under. Keep going. We just keep going through the two exercises over and over. We are almost there. Yeah. We got about 10 seconds. Hang in, Joanna. You're almost there. Last five. 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right. In here, if you can wipe down your equipment. And then we are going to switch sides. So if you were doing the wall ball on the bike, you will now be using the heavy rope. And if you were using heavy rope, you are going to set up for a wall ball and the bike. And you can adjust the seats of the bike. At home, here is where you're moving to either a dumbbell clean and press, where again, bringing both the dumbbells up and then driving overhead, catching and down. Or in Joanna's case, she's going to take a slam ball and throw it over. She's still cleaning and pressing. And then you have 10 burpees. Sorry, I am way overly explicit. I'm so sorry about that, Joanna. I just keep, can you tell that I have 4 kids and I repeat myself all day? Like I not only do I say it once, I say it 600 times. Exactly, yes. Sometimes I do that. I'm like, hey, where are your eyes? Are they here? So I can't really do that at home. So for those who didn't see, Joanna commented, thank you for the extra reminders. And I apologize for being incredibly explicit. All right, I'm going to give them the full 3 minutes. We'll let your heart rates drop just so that we can jack them up again in the next 50 seconds. We are going 30 seconds. And in here, those my zones, everybody is in the blue. I give it about 10 seconds before we're back in the yellow. 15 seconds. 10. Make sure we are ready for wall ball. We're ready for the heavy rope. We go 3, 2, 1. And go. Good. Yes, Joanna. Yeah. Solid work. Good work, Joanna. Yes. Good job on those burpees. If at home, Joanna, because in here they've got partners. So they do the wall ball together, but then they do the bike separately. You go, I go. If you want to take a minute to just kind of rest, get that heart rate back down, and then get started again. I should have said that the last round too, because there's some you go, I go, so little bits of rest. We are already 3 minutes in, over 3 minutes. Go work. Good burpees, Joanna. We are just over 6 minutes left. Hang in there, keep rolling through. Good job with those tosses, Joanna. Looks good. Good job going overhead. Yes. In solid form, squatting down and then lifting. Thank you. We're at the 4-minute mark. Just keep going through. We are almost there. You've done over 20 minutes of work. It's the last four. You can do this. Go work, Joanna. We are just over 2 minutes left. Hang in there, hang in there. Keep moving, keep moving. Yes. Solid work. It's your last minute, last 60 seconds. We got to keep moving. Almost there. Keep pushing, keep pushing. 40 seconds. You are almost there. Keep going. Go work on those wall balls, ladies. Good job. Keep pushing on that bike, Mike. Solid heavy rope jumps. Yes, Joanna, we're almost there. 20 seconds, 20 seconds. You can do this. Give me 10 seconds of hard work. This is it. In 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right. In here, if you can wipe down your equipment at home, you will not need to. That was solid work, everyone, honestly. Good stuff. I'm going to change your screen. As they're wiping down stuff in here, I'll explain at home what you need to do because you may need to go looking for some equipment. In here, we're going to use those PVC pipes. Okay. So at home, if you have like a rope, a broom, I don't know where rope came from. That is not even the word I was looking for. But if you have some kind of like a broom or a Swiffer or something, We're going to do the over and backs, and we're going to do some hollow rocks, and we're going to go the side to side. So you need something. I mean, we have different lengths in here and different girths and different weights and stuff, but something just super light. We're just working on mobility. All right. So they're going to finish wiping off, and then I'll explain. All right, as you're finishing up, last bit, I'm not going to time it. It's just three total rounds of mobility work with the PVC pipe. So three exercises, we do everything in sets of 10. So the first one is an over and back. So my hands are wide enough that I can lift my PVC pipe back and come forward. Going back and forward is one, and you do it 10 times. So back and forward is two. Three, and we go for 10 times. Then you hold your PVC pipe overhead and your hollow rocks forward and back is one, and then two and three. And then the last one is the side to side. So again, a wide grip, and you're almost touching the floor with the pipe, and then to the other side, that's one and then two. Okay. So it's just more about mobility more than anything else. Three rounds, everything sets of 10. So if you do not have a pipe, come on over. Doesn't matter. I think they're going to head out because they have meetings and stuff. All right, whenever you're ready. Sets of 10, over and back. Thank you for coming. Yeah. So all the way back. Yep. So we're straight, like, we are working on the mobility here, all of our shoulder blades and everything. So should be a little bit of a strain. Shouldn't hurt. If it hurts, don't. But you should be wide enough that you can get all the way back. Yes. It is a, yeah, because we're not used to going all the way back. Yes. Good work, Joanna. We're talking strategies for the combine, Joanna. Trying to figure out with all the different events and whatnot. If you are finished with your over and back and your hollow rocks and your side to side, recovery is the pigeon stretch and the child's pose. So the pigeon stretch has one leg in front and you're sitting down to kind of stretch the hip flexor on the back. Okay. And you switch legs, same thing, do about 30 seconds on each side. And then that child's pose is where your arms are in front and you sit back for about 30 seconds and you can go to each side as well. And again, usually for stretching, it sounds like a long time, but 30 seconds to really stretch out those muscles and relax and whatnot. But we're all finishing at different times. So it is your call. I am going to stop the recording from here. So I will say have a wonderful Thursday. Hopefully we see you on Saturday.